You don't know how to zoom in CapCut PC. I can fix that. All right, first things first. Open up CapCut and start a new project. Then, in the top left, make sure you're in the Media tab, and then click Import. Navigate to where your content is at, click it, and then click Open. Then it'll be added into this bin. Click and drag your content onto the timeline, and from here, you'll be able to choose the way you want to zoom. My two favorite ways are at the end of this video, so make sure you stay tuned. Click your clip, then in the top right, click on the Animation tab. And from here, you'll see the In tab, Out tab, and Combo tab. The In tab lets you add any of these effects to the beginning of your clip. The Out tab lets you add any of these effects to the end of your clip. And the Combo, well, it's kind of a combination of both, but we'll get into that. So click on the In tab. And if you scroll down a little bit, you can see that there's Zoom 1, Zoom 2, Zoom In, and Zoom Out. So for this, we'll use the Zoom In. Once you click your effect, it'll be added to the beginning of your clip. So I click it, then you can adjust the duration by either grabbing this slider or using this counter, and every time you make a change, it'll play in the preview window. So I have this 3 second zoom in and it just played. Then if you wanted to remove it, all you have to do is scroll up and click none. If we go over to the Out tab, you can see that it's pretty much the same premise, but it happens at the end of your video. So if I was to click this zoom in, it'll add it to the end of my video and I can change the duration. We're grabbing the slider, change it to 6.7 seconds, and it slowly zooms in at the end of my video or the end of my clip. Now, when I click, let's actually clear that. When I click the Combo tab and then I click on Zoom 2, it'll actually place that effect throughout my whole clip. So if I have this whole entire clip selected, it'll place the in of that effect right here and the out of that effect right here. So I can actually move this to be in the middle of my video to move that effect to a different spot. And you see right here, it's in the middle and it lasts for 2.6 seconds. And that's one thing I do like about the combination tab. But my method of doing this is a little bit different because sometimes I just want to add the in, I don't want to add an in and an out on my clip. So let's remove this and let's go back to the In tab. And let's say that I wanted to do that zoom in effect, the same one, but I didn't want to do it at the beginning of my video. Let's say I want to do it right about here. What I would do is split this clip so I can either click this split button or click Control B. And then it'll split this clip into two clips. So the beginning of this new clip is right here. So once I click zoom in, it'll add that zoom in to the middle of my whole entire video, but the beginning of this clip. And you can do the same thing with the Out tab up here. And I just like doing it this way. But let's undo all of that and put my clip back together. Now I can show you how to zoom with the Video tab. So on the top right, click the Video tab. And from here, you can adjust the scale. The scale is actually the zoom level. So if I adjust this slider and zoom out, it'll zoom me out. And if I zoom it in, it'll zoom me in. So let's set this back to 100%. And if I wanted to zoom in on one part of the video, so let's say you start the video like this, and this is the 100% zoom, and I wanted to do a quick zoom in at this point in time, then I would split the clip. And let's say I want to zoom in for about this amount of time, then I would split the clip again into this tinier clip. And this tinier clip is the clip that will be zoomed in. So I can actually click it and then change the scale to about 150. And when I move my playhead over, you can see that it's zoomed in more. But when I actually click play, it'll quickly zoom into that spot while I'm talking and then zoom out of that spot once that clip duration is done. But you're like, okay, well, I kind of want to do this automatically. I don't want to have to keep splitting it into different clips and whatnot. And you can do that too. So let's undo this effect. Let's put this clip back together. Zoom out a little bit. So let's say I wanted to start zooming in right about here. Another thing you can do is use keyframes. So I can start, if I wanted to start my zoom right about here, what you need to do is have a reference. So right now, the scale is at 100%. You want to click this keyframe right next to scale, and then you can, that will be a scale of 100. So you'd start the zoom right here at 100. Then where you want to end the zoom will be a little bit further down the line. So you drag your playhead to that point, and then you click your keyframe again and adjust your scale. So if I wanted to zoom out, I can just adjust my scale to about 60%. And then when I play it from the beginning part of the zoom, you can click play and it'll actually zoom out and it'll be like over time. And that's one thing I really love about keyframes, because it lets you dial in when you actually want to zoom in and zoom out without cutting up your clips. So if I wanted to restore this back to the same spot, I would pause the video where I want to restore it, and then I would change the zoom or the scale level back to 100%. And it will automatically add a keyframe. And then when I go back and click play, it'll zoom me out. And then right at this point in time, it will zoom me back in. And it'll go all the way back up to that 100%. And as you can see, the scale is moving to that position. So you can do that with zooming in and zooming out. If you didn't adjust your keyframe how you wanted, like if you didn't want this duration to be as long, then you can actually click and drag your keyframe along your clip and you can choose where you want it to be. So like if I want it to be a faster zoom, I just move it closer to my other keyframe. If I wanted to be like a really extended period of time that it's zooming, then you just bring it all the way out to the right. And once I click play, you see it just takes a lot longer for me to get back to that zoom level. But if I move it all the way really close to my other keyframe and press play, then you see, okay, well, it's zooming out. And then right at this point, it'll take a shorter amount of time to just pop back in. Please subscribe and check out my other videos for more CapCut PC help. Peace.